In the current financial year 2023-2024 budget, only 3.6 billion shillings was allocated towards road safety activities in the country, leaving a huge shortfall of 17.3 billion shillings that was required by various agencies to restore sanity on the roads.
I mean, road safety, had been neglected completely. It was only this particular budget that we talked and using the deputy speaker, we advocated what have until our cry was heard.
The recent upsurge of road accidents that have claimed lives, including that of businessman Apollo Nyegamehe and former Erut North MP Charles Gutomoe, in just 1 week, has reawakened legislators to demand for increased funding of road safety activities in order to mitigate the rampant road carnage.
Look at the budget of the Ministry of Works to do with road safety. Virtually, it has actually failed. They have even no monitoring unit. They have no even ambulance on the road. You see, everything has gone to the dogs.
Still, us making roads without signage, because signage play a very important role on a road infrastructure, a holistic road infrastructure.
Ugandan drivers who know how to use the road, who use the road consciously so that the deaths arising from overspeeding are avoided.
Road safety financing is still a major challenge due to failure by government to appreciate it as a priority. According to the annual crime report 2022, the country registered 20,394 cases of road accidents in 2022 compared to 17,443 registered in the previous year. Over 4,000 people perish in road crashes per year, and 61% of all accidents are as a result of reckless driving.
Be expanded, but at least there should be trucks to clear stationed vehicles, for example. Because it's a stationed vehicle, the assumption that has been there for over 30 minutes. But you see, there are so many stationary vehicles. The roads are really narrow, and there are no...
Now, legislators have urged government to establish a robust ambulance system on all highways to extend emergency services.
Improve the emergency medical service, which largely involves the ambulance system, to be able to ferry people or victims of accidents to the nearest hospital where they can get immediate medical attention.
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the News at Parliament.